Welcome children, take out your English literature book, Longman Impression, Revised Edition, Part 7, Chapter 9, The Umbrella Man. Before telling the story, let me tell you that this story is about a young girl and a mother who meets an old man on their way home and a strange incident happens. Now let's begin the story. I am going to tell you about a funny thing that happened to my mother and me yesterday evening. Now here the narrator is telling her own story. Now narrator, what she is telling that? She is telling that she wants to tell narrator funny incident that happened to the narrator and her mother the day before evening. I am 12 years old and I am a girl. My mother is 34, but I am nearly as tall as her already. Now, narrator. Narrator is what? Narrator is just a 12-year-old girl. And she's a girl. And her mother, narrator's mother, is 34 years old. But the narrator, though she is only 12 years old, but she is as tall as her mother. Yesterday afternoon, my mother took me to London to see the dentist. Now, the day before, what happened? Day before afternoon, what happened? Narrator's mother took the narrator to London, the London city, to visit a dentist. He found one hole. It was a black tooth and he filled it without hurting me too much. Now, actually the narrator had a cavity in her tooth. And so, the dentist had filled the hole without hurting the narrator. After that, we went to a cafe. After that, what happened? The narrator along with the mother went to a cafe. I had a banana split and my mother had a cup of coffee. Now, the narrator, she took a banana split and narrator's mother took a cup of coffee. By the time we got up to leave, it was about 6 o'clock. And by the time they got up to take the leave from the restaurant, it was near about 6 o'clock. When we came out of the cafe, it started to rain. Now, when they came out of the cafe, what happened? It was raining. We must get a taxi, my mother said. Now, narrator's mother said that they have to get a, means mother, narrator's mother said that they had to get a taxi because it was raining. We were wearing ordinary hats and coats and it was raining quite hard. And the narrator along with her mother, they were wearing ordinary hats and ordinary coats and it was raining quite hard. So the narrator's mother told that they needed a taxi to go back. Why don't you go back into the cafe and wait for it to stop? Oh, I said, I wanted another for those banana spills. They were gorgeous. Now narrator, as she was a child, she told her mother that she wanted to go back to the coffee because she wanted till the rain stopped, as because narrator, she found the banana split too tasty. It isn't going to stop, my mother said. We must get home. Now, narrator's mother said that the rain is continuing and it is not going to stop. So, and it is very necessary to reach home. We stood on the pavement in the rain looking for a taxi. Now, both of them, they stood on the pavement and in the rain, they stood on the pavement and they were looking for a taxi. Lots of them came by, but they all had passengers inside them. Now, lots of taxi passed by, but all the taxis had passengers inside them. I wish we had a taxi with a chauffeur, my mother said. Now, narrator's mother said that she wished that if she had a car with a driver. Just then a man came up to us. He was a small man and he was pretty old, probably 70 or more. Just then, in the meantime, what happened? One man came up. What was his height? He was a very short-heighted man and he was quite old man. Probably he was 70 years or more than 70 years. He raised his head politely and said to my mother, excuse me, I do hope you will excuse me. Now, politely, what happened when they reached near the narrator and her mother? He raised his hat politely and said to the narrator's mother, excuse me, I hope you will excuse me. I had a fine moustache. He had a fine moustache and bushy white earbows and a wrinkly pink face. Now, how was the look of the old man? He had a white mustache, bushy white brows, and wrinkly pink eyes. He was sheltering under an umbrella which he held high over his head. Now, what he was doing? He was carrying an umbrella over his head. Yes, my mother inquired, very cool and distant. Now, Netta's mother inquired that yes, he was very cool and distant. He said, I wonder if I could ask a small favor. He said, it's only a very small favor. Now, what happened? The man, what he said, he was saying that I wonder that if I can say, means the man was saying, old man was saying that if he could ask for a small favor, it was just a small favor. I saw my mother looking at him suspiciously. She is a suspicious person, my mother. Now, narrator found that narrator's mother was looking at the man in a very suspected way. Netta's mother, she was a very suspicious lady. She is specially suspicious of two things, strange men and boiled eggs. Now, Netta's mother, she was suspicious of two things. That is, one is strange men and boiled eggs. When she cuts off the top of a boiled egg, she pokes around inside it with her spoon and though expecting to find a mouse or something. Now, what she does, whenever she cuts off the top of a boiled egg, what she does? She looks around it inside with a spoon and look very carefully that she hopes that maybe she could find a mouse or something else from inside. With strange men, she has a golden rule to say. Now, for strange men, she had a different rule, she used to say. The nicer the man seems to be, the more suspicious you must become. Now, according to the narrator's mother, the nicer the person, the more suspicious one should become. The little old man was particularly nice, and this little old man, it was really looking a very good man. He was polite, he was well spoken, he was well dressed. Now that man, what type of he was? Very particular man, particularly he was a very nice man, he was a very polite man, he was well spoken man and even very well dressed man. He was a real gentleman and the man, what he looked very gentle. The reason I knew he was a gentleman was because of his shoe. Now reason what he knew that he was a gentleman and because why he looked gentleman because of his shoes. You can always spot a gentleman by the shoe he wears was man another of the mother's favorite say. Now one can always spot a gentleman by how? By the shoes one wears. That was another of the mother's favorite say. The man had beautiful brown eyes. Even that man, what he had beautiful eyebrow, beautiful brown shoes. The truth of the matter is that the little man was saying, I have got myself into a bit scrap. Now, what problem the little man had? The little man said that he had a problem that he had fallen into a difficult situation. I need some help, not much, I assure you. Now, the man said that he needs some help, not much. He just requested. It's almost nothing, in fact, but I do need it. You see, madam, old people like me become terribly forgetful. Now, what that man said, and he said that he was assuring, he tell that, you know that old people like me, madam, he always forget. He becomes very forgetful person. My mother's chin was up and she was staring down at him along the full length of her nose. Now, the narrator's mother's chin, she was looking up and she was looking down at the narrator's nose. It was a fearsome thing, this frosty nose stare of my mother. Now, what happened? That staring of a mother, what was it? It was really little fearsome. Most people go to pieces completely when she gives it to them. Now, most people, what happened? They go to pieces very completely when they give them. I saw my own headmistress begin to stammer her and simper when my mother gave her a real foul, frosty noser. Now, what he saw? The what she saw means the narrator, what she saw from a own mistake, it began to stammer and was saying, the mother gave up a really, Miss the narrator's mother was really giving a different look. But the little man on the pavement with the umbrella over his head didn't bat an eyelid. But the little man who was standing on the pavement and with an umbrella, he didn't at all batted his eyelid. He gave a gentle smile. Now what the little man did, he just gave a gentle smile and said, I beg you to believe, madam, that I am not in the habit of stopping ladies in the street and telling them about. Now that old man said that, you believe me, madam, that you believe me. He was assuring the narrator's mother. The old man was assuring the narrator's mother that he doesn't have the habit of stopping the ladies in the street and then telling him about his trouble. I should hope not, my mother said. Now, narrator's mother said that she also hoped that she doesn't and believe it. I felt quite embarrassed by my mother's sharpness. Now, narrator, she felt very embarrassed by the mother's sharpness. I wanted to say to her, oh, mummy, for heaven's sake, he's a very old man and sweet and polite. Now, the narrator felt pity on the old man and she wanted to say her mother that, oh, mother, for heaven's sake, this man, means that old man, he was a very old man and he was very sweet and polite and he is in sort of trouble, so don't be beastly to him, and that man, he has fallen in some trouble and so don't act like a beastly. But I didn't say anything. But the narrator didn't say anything. The little man shifted his umbrella from one hand to another. Now, little man, what he did? He shifted his umbrella from one hand to another. I have never forgotten it there before, he said, saying that never I have. He had never forgotten it before. The old man said these things. You have never forgotten what? But mother asked sternly. Now, the narrator's mother sternly asked that, never, what you have never forgotten? My wallet, he said. The old man said, that his wallet. I must have left it in my other jacket. Isn't that the silliest thing to think that? I must have meant the narrator, old man was saying that he had left his wallet in the other jacket and it is a very silly thing. Are you asking me to give you some money? My mother said. Now, narrator's mother asked that, do you want some money? Are you telling to give him some money? Oh, good gracious me, no, he cried. Heaven forbid, I should never do that. Now, that old man said that, oh, good gracious, I will never do such thing. I will never do such thing. Then, what are you asking? My mother said, do hurry up. Now, narrator's mother asked that, okay, then what are you asking for? Just tell quickly. We are getting soaked to skin here, saying that we are getting dry here only. I know you are, he said. Now he said that he knew who you are. That, and that's why I am offering you this umbrella of mine to protect you and to keep forever if. Now, what the old man did, he said that he wanted to offer his umbrella to the narrator's mother and said that to keep that umbrella forever. If only what, my mother? Now saying that, now narrator's mother asked that if only what? If only if you give me in return a pound for my taxi fare just to get home. Saying that in return, if you give me one pound to for the taxi fare so that I can return back. My mother was still suspicious. Now the narrator's mother, she was still suspicious. If you had no money in the first place, she said, then how did you get here? Now the narrator's mother asked that, in the first place, if you had no money, then how the old man came here? Now take out your diary, write chapter 9, The Umbrella Man, 3 pages, explain, homework, revise it. And with this, I'm ending my today's class. Goodbye.